The week that the Blitz on Britain started is being commemorated in a big way. A host of books is being published on the subject. There are exhibitions all over the capital. And to remind us of the folklore that surrounded people's lives in 1940 and 1941, Lionel Bart is reviving his 60s musical called Blitz, which is now rehearsing with the National Youth Theatre.
I think that this is a show about the fortitude of a people under a lot of stress and the way communities existed. People looked after each other. They cared about each other's survival.
At the time of the real Blitz, though, the authorities were deeply worried about people's survival and about what the effect of a sustained bombing campaign on Britain would be. London itself was no stranger to bombing, of course. German Zeppelin airships dropped bombs over the capital early on in the First World War, and giant Gotha biplane bombers did the same later on. The fear of what modern bombing could achieve there was heightened by strategic thinking in Britain and elsewhere that the bomber would always get through, and that casualties would be high, and that the civilian population would not be able to take it. In the event, as this exhibition at the Museum of London shows, Britain could and did take it. The Blitz started on September the 7th, 1940, and continued on to the following May, with London the city most attacked. The aim was to break the morale of the civilian population, and by doing so, to break the will of the armed forces to fight on. In spite of terrible destruction and terrible casualties, 90,000 were killed or wounded, the people of Britain won through. Although our morale didn't break in the Blitz, it didn't stop us in our turn from bombing Germany later on in an effort to break their morale. During the 3.5-year Blitz on Germany, over 1 million Germans were killed or maimed. That's more than 10 times as many casualties as we suffered in our Blitz. But although we did succeed in severely damaging the German war economy from October 1944 onwards, we did not succeed in breaking their morale either. And in the many little wars that have followed the Second World War, civilians and their cities have been bombed again, and civilian morale has not been broken again. Surely one of the great tragedies of the Blitz is not just that 90,000 people were killed or wounded, although God knows that's tragedy enough. Perhaps one of the greatest tragedies is that we do not seem to have learnt the lesson of the Blitz, that just bombing people out of their hearths and homes just doesn't win wars. This is Christopher Rainbow at the Museum of London for Thames News.